We use our joints every day for every move we make. You just scrolled the feed to this video. You clicked your mouse, you sat, you clutched your mug full of hot tea. Thank you, joints. Even something tiny like blinking uses a lot of joint power. Joints hold your entire body together, even if you're just lying on the sofa. They help you move, digest food, even think. If you have bones, you have joints. They make us flexible, able to adapt to what we see and hear. Our body moves when our muscles contract across our joints, moving our bones. Simple and elegant. They're attached to your bones, and your bones make up your skeleton. There's only one bone in your entire body that has no joints, out of more than 200. This special bone is the hyoid, the one that's in your throat and supports your tongue. Your skeleton has two parts, the axial and the appendicular. The axial part has about 80 bones, like your skull, back, rib cage. The appendicular parts are all the rest, all the bones in your legs and arms. Every single bone's connected to one another through a joint, or a couple of them. You've even got them in your skull. It's not just one solid piece, it's made up of 8 parts, with joints holding them together. Without these joints, our brain wouldn't be able to grow properly. Our skull joints aren't flexible like our knees or elbows, they hardly move at all. Not all joints are supposed to be flexible. Still, without them, life would be much different. People with smaller heads would have smaller brains, and we don't want that. We'd all be stuck with brains about the same size as when we were born. A regular adult's head would be about half its normal size. Apart from those skull bones, there are 14 more bones around your head, basically your face and jaw. Together, these bones do a lot of great things. You use them whenever you eat, smell, talk, sing. Without joints, we could say goodbye to eating, drinking, and even breathing. Wow! A world without joints would have no friendly chats, yummy snacks, or smelling your morning coffee. Living without oxygen seems impossible, but people might learn how to breathe through their skin and get enough nutrients directly from the sun. No more restaurants, grocery stores, or living in cloudy places. What about bones? Aren't they the real stars? Not really. There are so many living things that have no bones at all. Let's take ants. No bones. But they're one of the strongest creatures out there. A tiny ant can drag an entire leaf up the side of a tree. But no bones doesn't necessarily mean no joints. Ants and many other insects actually do have joints in their legs and neck. They're the reason they can lift so much. And it's not like they don't have a skeleton. Theirs is on the outside of their body. So, many creatures don't have bones, but they still have joints. So, maybe having no joints would mean having no skeleton at all? With zero bones, we'd all be very vulnerable. Even if we had a shell on the outside, like ants do, we wouldn't be able to protect our prized possession, our brain. If people didn't have bones, their brain would be in danger all the time. Even bumping into something could spell real trouble. We would look like worms, slugs, or jellyfish, a gooey body with no bones or joints. But with our bulky brain, we'd need protection. People might look like a hagfish, which has a skull but no spine. Just like these fish, people would produce slime all over their body. Wow! You wouldn't have hands or legs to grab stuff with or just to walk around with. No more picking up and using anything. No more computers, phones, forks, spoons, nothing. The only thing you'd care about are your gills, and you'd need that slime to distract and confuse your enemies. So, if people had no joints, they'd probably live in a completely different environment. Maybe like a jellyfish, swimming around in the tropics, or a worm living in the soil. There are way more boneless animals living in the water, oceans, rivers, lakes, that kind of thing. You'd probably be in there too. But if you had no joints and looked like earthworms, you might use the same techniques as they do to move. Worms are covered with tiny bristles. These bristles help them grip the surface they're on while they push their bodies forward. Without joints, you might have to be covered with bristles too. And since the average person is way larger than any earthworm, your bristles would have to be much bigger. But your new life would come with other major changes to your body. Goodbye lungs, hello gills. your skin would need to adapt and become rougher. Or maybe you'd start growing scales to be able to live underwater. Aquatic life sounds fun, but it would take some major getting used to. You'd have to learn how to swim like a pro, learn what underwater plants and algae you can eat, and learn to watch out for hungry sharks. Every time you push a shopping cart, dance to your favorite song, walk the dog, write a text, or even watch videos like this one, you need joints. Without joints, your body would be so different. Your legs would be one solid bone, same with your arms. And over half of your bones are in your feet and hands. They'd be useless. You'd have to use electric scooters or a self-balancing scooter to get around. And this tech better be good, because if you fell over, you'd probably really hurt yourself. It doesn't matter, because without joints, you wouldn't even be able to stand up or lie down. You'd never be able to get on that scooter, let alone get out of bed. But don't count yourself out just yet. Your body is super adaptable. You wear out your joints just going about your daily life. Strains, sprains, and many other injuries might make that happen faster. But what if you never needed your joints in the first place? No more sprained ankles playing soccer. No more tennis elbow. What if your bones could work perfectly without them? Your bones would need to become way softer and more bendy. So you'd need a brand new structure. Bones are hard and can't bend because of what they're made of. So back to the drawing board. Bones would need to be more like cartilage, the stuff your ears and nose are made of. Cartilage is tough and way more flexible than bone. Nose and ear cartilage are okay, but you'd need something else, something flexible, tough, and powerful. You'd need something like rubber. Remember those bendy pencils? Twist them, tie them in a knot, bend them. They always go back to their original shape. That's what you'd need for your arms and legs. One potential problem is that your new bones wouldn't be able to carry as much weight. You and everyone else would have to shed quite a few pounds. Rubbery bones would be much lighter than real bones, so people would weigh less anyway. Right now, your skeleton is about 15% of your body mass. If you had rubbery bones, you'd weigh about 10% less. The best thing about rubber bones is that they don't break. You'd be able to twist yourself up like a pretzel and still bounce back, good as new. Sprains and strains would be a bit different too. There wouldn't be joint pain, obviously, and you wouldn't need to wear any sort of brace on your knee, wrist, or ankle to keep them from moving while they heal. Even if you bent your limbs way around too much and they got totally deformed, you'd just need to wait a bit until everything was back to normal. Think of what you could do with a rubber skeleton. You could hide almost anywhere or be amazing at yoga. You could stretch up and reach the top shelf in the kitchen and dunk like a pro. It might take some practice, but your rubber bones would be life-changing.